May God bless the worship team. Because they bless us. Even if you wind up right here, I've gotten my portion. Because this song that we just ended with. That even if the sorrow may be much, I'm at peace. It is well with me. You know, sometimes, brethren, there are things that we say, but we get used to that. We take it for granted. And even in sorrow, what will I do? I will sing that, that it is well with me. It is well with me. That is a testimony. And let me tell you this, my brethren. Even if you may miss out everything I'm going to say, please don't miss out on the song that I sing. So because the time of worship, it's not a time to warm the seats and the benches so that we warm the place, so that when people come, they find this place is warm. There are things that we are telling God, but we're also confessing some things to the spiritual world. And there are things that we are telling our hearts. There are times that David would, and if he was a preacher, and even if I don't have anyone to preach to, let me preach to my heart. And say, oh my heart, praise God. And everything that is beginning, let it praise the Lord. So don't take that moment as a moment to warm ourselves. God has already spoken. And when he has already started speaking, pay attention, please. Because maybe your thing or your portion is in the song. So, and then what I'm about to say belongs to others. So all that is possible as you are going to see in the world. So we're going to pray. Father, I humble myself before you. I thank you for what you've done in my life and my family and the LR Ministries. I thank you for that car that you've given us. And we pray for it to be a blessing for your kingdom. We pray that it glorifies you in everything. We pray that whoever is going to enter into that car, that you will bless them in the name of Jesus. We pray for the person who gave it to us. And we pray for all that you did to our brother that we couldn't say. Receive it all as thanksgiving and praise to you. Because you've been good to us. Because you've been with us. Because you protected us. And now you brought us to your house so that we hear your word. I'm humbling myself that you use me today. That is speak with me, you speak with our brethren, so that you change and transform us together as you want. We, all the glory be yours. We welcome you, Holy Spirit. Come and speak to us. Come and walk with us. Come and change us. Come and rebuke us. Come and bring us together on one for the glory of your Lord. It's in the name of Jesus that we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
We are
going to read a few scriptures. Even though we're going to talk about many of them, but let's start in John. John chapter 14, 15-26.
Those who have English Bibles, please follow in your own Bibles. Nimunkunda muzitondera amategeko yanjye, nanjye nzasaba Data nawe azabaha undi mufasha wo kubana namwe ibihe byose. Niwe mwuka w'ukuri, nibishoboka ko abisi bamuhabwa kuko batamurora kandi batamuzi, ariko mwebweho muramuzi kuko abana namwe kandi azaba muri mwe. Sinzabasiga n'imfubyi, ahubwo nzazaho muri. Hasigaye umwanya muto abisi ntibabe bakimbona, ariko mwebwe muzambona kuko ndiho namwe muzabaho. Haleluya. Uomunsi muzamenya ko ndi muri data. Namwe mukaba muri nge, nange nkaba muri mwe. Ufite amategeko yange akayitondera ni unkunda. Kandi unkunda azakundwa na data. Nange nzamukunda mwiyereka. Yuda utari Iskariota aramubaza ati data uja bibaye bite kugiye kutwiyereka ntiwiyereka bise. Yesu aramusubiza ati umuntu nankunda azitondera ijambo ryanjye na data azamukunda. Tuzaza wari tugumane nawe. Ariko utankunda nitondera amagambo yanjye kandi iryo jambo mwumvise sibyo siryanjye ahubwo ni irya data wandumye. Ariko utankunda nitondera amagambo yanjye kandi iryo jambo mwumvise siryanjye ahubwo ni irya data wandumye. Ibyo mbibabwiriye nkiri kumwe nawe. Ariko umufasha ari we Mwuka Wera uwo data azatuma mu izina ryanjye niwe uzabigisha byose abibutse ibyo nababwiye byose. Imana yacu ishimwe cyane.
Amen.
Turasoma nanone mu butumwa bwiza bwa Yohana mu gice cya 10.
Now chapter 10 of the same book.
Turasoma umurongo wa mbere
verse 1
tugere ku murongo wa 5
to verse 5.
Hanyuma turaza gusimbuka dusoma umurongo wa 27 wonyine.
And we'll jump to verse 27 alone.
Ijambo ry'Imana riravuga ngo nukuri nukuri ndababwira yuko uwinjira mu rugo rw'intama atanyuze mu irembo ahubwo akuririra ahandi uwo aba ari umujura n'umunyazi. Ariko unyura mu irembo niwe mwungeri w'intama. Umurinzi w'irembo aramwugururira kandi intama zumva ijwi rye ahamagara intama ze mu mazina yazo akazaho. Iyo amaze kwahura ize zose azijya imbere intama zikamukurikira kuko zizi ijwi rye. Undi ntizimukurikira ahubwo ziramuzamuhunga kuko zitazi amajwi y'abandi. Umurongo wa 27 akavuga ngo intama zanjye zumva ijwi ryanjye nanjye ndazizi kandi zirankurikira. Imana yacu ishimwe cyane.
Amen.
Muri ibi bihe turimo ni ibihe byo kuvuga ku Mwuka Wera.
We are in the times where we are talking about the Holy Spirit.
Ibi bihe byaguye abantu mu buryo butandukanye.
The times that have impacted many people differently.
Hari abanejejwe no kwiga Mwuka Wera.
Some were rejoicing because of learning about the Holy Spirit.
Kubera ko hari ibintu bungutse ku Mwuka Wera.
Because they learned some things about the Holy Spirit.
Kubera ko hari ibintu batangiye kugenderamo mu Mwuka Wera.
And things they've started to walk into some things with the Holy Spirit.
Hari n'abandi bagize ibyo bibutswa ku Mwuka Wera.
Others were reminded about some things about the Holy Spirit. But there are other people who did not like it, or they did not enjoy. There are people who did not partake of these times. And they are wondering how or when are we going to go back to our old times. So they are saying, are you going to become like anyone? These Holy Spirit things.
Tuzongera dusubire muri bya bihe bya Omega ryari.
When are we going to go back to this moment of Omega?
Ariko reka mugire mwene data.
But let me tell you my brethren. The Bible says,
ukuri dusohoye
that the truth we are walking in is
abariko dukurikiza.
That we should walk accordingly.
Ibi ni byo bihe bishya bya Omega.
So this is new times of Omega.
Ntabwo ntekereza ko Imana izadusubiza inyuma.
I don't believe that we're going to go back to those
moments.
But we're actually moving forward.
Nawe rero ngwi.
So you ought to go with us. Don't wait for us to end this month of the Holy Spirit. Because you see that it wasn't actually 1 month. It started with being 1 month. Now it's 2 months. And I believe that it's going to stay forever actually. If we may not speak about the Holy Spirit, but we'll be walking in the Holy Spirit, walking in the power of the Holy Spirit, because these are the moments God has prepared for us and He wants to walk in them. But I may understand you, brethren, Because you learned a lot of things. And some of them may get you confused actually. They are telling us that Holy Spirit is God. That when He comes, He brings gifts. That He comes and gives us His fruit. Now Holy Spirit and prayer. So it may be too much for someone. But what is the purpose of all that? What is the purpose? That's what I want to talk about.
Briefly.
And then I'll also talk about what God has given me. Today's teaching is the Holy Spirit and hearing the voice of God. Because it doesn't serve us to say that we are walking the Spirit if we are not hearing the voice of God. You can come to me and tell me that you are walking the Spirit and you
can
hear the voice of God. Because sometimes we mystify it. And then when you want to intimidate people, you say that I'm in the spirit. And if you don't want people to confront you about your sins, you say that you are in the spirit. So the purpose of God during this moment is what? That's what I want to talk about briefly. Let me remind you what we say that the Holy Spirit is not another thing, but the Holy Spirit is God.
Yes, Hashem.
Praise Jesus.
The
Holy Spirit is God. Because the God that we pray is
a God in three.
That's the God in three persons. So we have the God the Father, God the Son, which is Jesus Christ, and we have God the Holy Spirit, which is the Holy
Spirit.
So three people, as usual. One person. So we are saying that we have one God in three persons. So let them hold hands.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Harimana Data.
We have God the Father.
Harimana Mungana.
We have God the Son.
Ariko dufite n'Imana Mukawe.
And we have also the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mubihe bya Yesu Kristo.
During the times of Jesus Christ.
Mbere yuko Maria Samina.
Before Mary conceived.
Imana yatumye kuri Yosefu.
God sent to Joseph
Maria,
when he was about to divorce Mary and said, no, don't do that, because the child that is bearing is not an ordinary one. It is from the Holy Spirit. So there is God the Son who made like an embryo. If you can understand that, God bless you. But sometimes I don't understand. To understand the humility of Jesus Christ. Imagine creating a woman and then you enter into that woman. And he said, don't send him away because he's going to be a son. Call him Jesus Christ. Because he's the one who's going to remove the sins of the world. But one of the prophecies says his other name is going to be
Emmanuel.
He's going to be Emmanuel. God with us. In other words, God and his three persons do not like to stay there. And he said that I want to dwell
with my people.
And that prophecy came from Jeremiah. From chapter
31:23.
And he said that these people are going to be my people. They'll be called my people. I'll be called their God. And I'll dwell with them. And then the time of Jesus came. And Jesus Christ came in the world.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Aba Emmanuel.
And he became Emmanuel. God among his people. He did all the miracles that we know. And before he left, he said that I can see your concern, but please do not worry that in my father there are many houses. There is a time I'm going to come and tell you
about.
But there is an interim period. There is a period between when I'm saying that and the time it
is.
So I am going back to my father. But I'm not going to leave you as orphans. So the good thing is that I go back to the father. Because when I get to the father,
hallelujah.
Amen. For those who believe in my
word,
according to it and obey
it,
I will tell my father so that he says,
hallelujah.
Amen. I wish and pray that you can understand this
thing.
Imagine being left like orphans here on earth. But he said that I will not leave
you. I'm
going back to my father. And then I will ask my father to send you the Holy Spirit. That one is going to lead
hallelujah.
You in every truth. You know another amazing thing? He said, you know, that he who obeys my
rules
and who takes my word and keeps it, I will love him. But it's not me alone. Even the Father will love him. And at the end, we'll come and be with him. How? Because of the presence of the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So when we talk about the Holy Spirit,
it's
something that we've seen outside here. That is different from God. That is coming into the life of our
brother.
But the Holy Spirit comes as God, who is
yes,
praise Jesus. And he comes to help
yes,
us. The Bible says that he is a helper. Now, it's not a helper as a woman or a wife. It's not a helper as a wife. But it's a helper that is even beyond. That word which says helper, it means another one like me. So Jesus said, I'm going, but I'm going to send you another one like me. So he was going to be with you. He will walk with you. He will dwell with you. He will lead you in all
things.
He will take off my word because it belongs to the Father, and he will give it to
you.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So when we talk about the Holy Spirit, you should not be afraid, but you should rejoice, right? Because this is what God wants about all. He wants us to commune with him. Because even though the Holy Spirit is with us, so I cannot split this process. He is with us, but he's also with us at the same time. The word of God says that he knows all
things
of
God,
and he also knows the thoughts of God. So he goes and takes
the Father,
and he comes and reveals it to you. Amen. He takes of the Father and he comes and reveals it to you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I
wish
you
that you will rejoice that the Holy Spirit is with you. Because this Holy Spirit is here to help us to commune with God.
Yes,
amen. I believe that one of the reasons why God has given us this moment to talk about the Holy Spirit is because many, we live in a Christianity that is not full. Even if you may not walk in all the gifts that we
have,
please stop being in that
Christianity.
Be in that Christianity where you listen to what the Father is saying, communion with the Holy Spirit. The one that works with the Father. Do you know what the Holy Spirit does? So he's brought us in this place. He's brought us in this place. Because of the Holy Spirit with whom we are.
Through
being led by him, we can know the wisdom of God. We can know the thought of God. That's why Paul says that even though we walk as human beings, but the weapons of our warfare, they are not kind or human. They are powerful to destroy all strongholds and put down every thought. It takes captive every thought that elevates itself against Christ. Is it because I come from
Canada?
Is it because I went to school? Because I learned theology? Just because of the presence of the Holy Spirit. So he brings me to God, and he makes me stand with God, and I walk in the power of God, and I do some things.
Yes,
hallelujah. So my dear brethren, you should not be scared about this moment, because what God wants
is this moment.
He wants you to bring
He
wants you to know how to have a communion with God. This, not this percent of leading yourself. Or to... whereby you are just guessing, you take it at the right of
God.
You have to live in a Christianity whereby you know the thought of God. That is what I want to walk in. Dear Christians, if you do not walk with the Holy Spirit, I am also missing out. When you're not walking with the Holy Spirit, I also miss out. When I'm not walking with the Holy Spirit, you also are missing out. Do not take, therefore, the
teaching.
Where he says that I will let them go into these Holy Spirit things, and when they get to heaven, they will come back and then walk together again. We don't want to miss out on anything that God wants to do. We don't want to miss out being lifted up to the measure that God wants. So do not stay behind. Do not be
behind.
But come into this
relationship with
God. Come in this relationship
with
God. Allow the Holy Spirit to speak to you. Allow the Holy Spirit to speak to you. Because if the Holy Spirit works with you, there are many things that you're going to change in your life. Please go back. Thank you. Let's ask for them. The time I'll get the reward for today, I will also be standing next to me, because we partook of this blessing. So before that time, Jesus told the people who were with him, and he said, you know what? You know, my sheep know me, and I also know them. The second thing is, they know my voice, and I even know their names. Those who were born in large families, mine was not too big, but my mom was like that. Because she was the third.
I was.
Yeah, you. Okay. Because he was the third born. When my mom wanted to call me, sometimes she was confused. And then she'll get confused until she mentions my name. That is not how Jesus Christ is. He knows your name. He knows you well. He knows where you came from. I was talking with some people. We met and then we began to talk about where we came from. And I told them that I come actually from Nyungwe Forest. Please do not joke with me. I come from that. Because it was possible that I'd be born in Nyarutarama. But God willed that I be born in Nyungwe, close to Nyungwe, so that I'll be able to also to help those who are
from,
so that I help them with some terminology in Kinyarwanda, so that I'll also be able to help those who were born there. Amen. So that I help those who are
yes,
born there. So he knows all of them. He knows their name. I wish you knew this. So that you know that Jesus Christ knows you. When he's about to call you, when he's about to talk to you, he doesn't use out his strength. He calls your name straight. He calls your name straight. That is portion of his part. You also have your part. You also have to know his voice. He says that my sheep, I know them. I know their names. I call each one by name. But they also have to do something. They need or they ought to know my name.
My
they don't follow other people because they don't know their voice. Unfortunately, is that many Christians, we do not know the voice of Jesus Christ. We do not know his voice. We just follow the crowd. But we do not know the voice of Jesus.
Christ.
So that when we hear his voice, we can distinguish his voice. We are many people who are
sitting
here. When they say that God says, they say we are going back to the Pentecostal church now. But that's not it, my brother. It's the Bible. It is the Bible in the Word of God. God wants to speak with you. And let me tell you this. There are people who are not able to hear the voice of God because they are saying they are self-pity, you know. They are in self-pity. They say, would God speak to me too? Who am I so that God will speak to me? I'm not Pastor Eddie. I'm not even a deacon in church. I'm not even leading any HDF. So would God really speak to me? I'm actually even a fresh born again. I don't even understand these things. So would God speak to me too? But let me tell you this, my brethren. He's been talking to you many times. He's been talking to you for some time. So what you need to do is to pay attention and listen to his voice. Is to listen to his voice. We need to hear his voice. We need to hear his voice. Because God wants to speak with you. Please hear his voice. Let me mention a few ways God can speak to you. I'm
going
to mention about 10 ways God can speak to you. If you have where to write, please write it down. The first way is it's through his word. Through his word. It's not in vain or per accident that the Bible is called the word of God. So the fact that it's a word, it means it has someone who spoke it. And we say it properly in our language, even in English, yeah. that it's the word of God. So meaning that the word or a word is equal to the one who spoke it. 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16, the Bible says, the word of God says about itself that all scriptures, that all scriptures say every scripture were inspired by God. It's not just those verses that you like or that bless you. It's not only the New Testament. It's not just those few verses that you learn and you memorize. But the Bible says every scripture were breath or inspired by God. And the Bible says that they are useful to teach a person, to train the person in righteousness, to rebuke the person, and also to cleanse the person. And around verse 17 it says, so that the person of God or the man of God has everything that he needs, so that he will be able to do every good and righteous work. So that he will be able to do every good work. So every scripture, he speaks to us through them. You might tell yourself, the Bible has 66 books. How will I know, for instance, which book is talking about the job that I'm applying to? That is not your job. That's the job of the Holy Spirit. There are passages and scriptures that is called logos. It's the written word. And there's also another one called rema. That is the inspired word of God, which speaks to you in a particular circumstance. So we need logos, the written word. And we also need rema, the inspired word of God. So that word that God speaks to you, and you know that this is God speaking to me. And you've read this passage for many years. And maybe you could even have preached about it. But when you read it today, you lift up your hands and say, because God has used this word to speak to you. So that's why I'm encouraging you, my brethren. Read the word of God. Read the word of God. It's not enough to come and hear it. It's not just enough to read it like the past. Just dive in it. Dive in it. And learn it. And memorize it. Do you think that Jesus Christ took a scroll to the desert? There are times that the devil is going to attack you and you won't have your Bible next to you. So that's why you need to keep it in your heart and mind. You need to keep it in your mind. And it should not only be in your mind, but also in your heart. David wrote in Psalm 119 that, oh Lord, I've hidden your word in my heart, so that I will not sin against you. That's why you need to learn the word of God and you get to know it. Because every other thing that I'm going to talk about, the ways, different ways God speaks to you, if it comes and it's contrary to what you have in the word, that's a sign that shows that this Because God cannot contradict himself in his word. So meaning that if you don't know the word of God, it's very easy for you to go astray. You can actually go astray in the name of Jesus. You can also bring other people astray in the name of Jesus. There are so many things going around here. Let me talk about one. I went to town. I just passed somewhere and I didn't know what
the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter Days.
And I saw a temple, a worship place, where it is written the Church of Jesus Christ of the Latter
Days.
So you may think that this is a place where Jesus Christ is worshipped. But do you know one of the things they believe? They believe that Jesus Christ is brother to Satan. Recently when I went to the US, I went to where the church originated from. They even built like the stairs or steps where Jesus Christ is going to come down and he returns. Don't they talk about Jesus? But if you don't know what the word of God says, those will come and take you. They are commonly known as Mormons. But they don't write that. They call the Church of Jesus Christ of the Latter Days. Is it not Omega? Is Omega not the Church of the Latter Days? And then when you come to them, you say, my fellow brethren, so if you don't know the word of God, they even have a lot of money. And they are even waving the money like this. And when they go preach, they are very properly dressed. They are dressed in white shirts and they even have badges with their names. So that we won't confuse them and take them as mayor people. So that's why knowing the word of God, to know the word of God, it will help you to actually be able to examine those things. So that is the first way God speaks to us through his word. The second one is to hear the voice of God in two ways. You can hear the voice of God just as I'm talking to you right now. We hear it with your ears. And when you look around, you can't find who's speaking. And God has spoken to you. I was praying. I remember one time I was in prayer. 2001. I was in some forest. I was praying. And I was praying for other things. And then I heard a voice saying, Lambert, pray for your marriage. I was a very zealous servant of God who is minding his business. So in 2001, he couldn't tell me about love and marriage and all these things. I was rebuking those things. For the second time, the voice came, Lambert, pray for your marriage. And then on the third time, and I said, but God, I think you are the one. So I began to pray for my marriage. From 2001. When was it answered? It took 12 years for it to be answered. So that the little one was also here. So it means, so do not be discouraged. So I want you to be helped by that. So you may hear the voice of God. Isaiah chapter 30, verse 21, the Bible says, that you hear a voice behind your ear when you are about to take either the right or the left. So you may hear that voice in your ears. But you can also hear that voice in your heart. And you know that this is God who just spoke to me. And you know that these are not just my thoughts. There is no way Lambert in his flesh and blood would think of these things. Because there is an inspiration that just came to you. So when you hear that voice in your heart or in a tangible voice, you need to pay attention because God is telling you something. Another way, that no, is not by many, is through dreams. The angel of God spoke to Joseph through a dream. Even Paul the apostle, through a dream where a person from Macedonia was calling him to be with them. And then in the morning, he knew that God was calling him to go to Macedonia. You may see that in Acts of Apostles. So dreams can be a way to which God speaks to you. But be careful. There are also dreams that come from the thoughts and the toilet. Because of the things that I've pictured, the pictures that I've taken throughout the day, let me tell our brethren, our young people, there are times that you are taking pictures about a certain moment. Because when you see her, you know, your heart is pumping. And then you try to imagine, when we get married, how will I be looking? And you try to imagine, you know, having kids and all that. And you've taken all those many pictures during the day. And then you take it to the lab to develop the pictures for dreams. So with the old school cameras, you would take the film and you develop it in a dark room. So sometimes it happens to us as Christians as well. Sometimes it's like that. Because we've taken a lot of pictures. And then when we get to the dark room, which is our bed, then we develop pictures. But there are other dreams where you have them, you know that this is God's
purpose.
That's why if you remember any dreams, pray about it and ask God
to teach
you. And tell God, you're speaking to this. Was it just ordinary dreams? Or you are talking to me through this?
Another way God can speak
to you, God can speak to us through a vision. And you are not asleep, you are fully awake. And God shows you some things. And he shows you some things and you see them. And sometimes you may even close your eyes and you see some things, but it's not like you are dreaming, it's real things that God is showing you. And God speaks to you through that. Cornelius, when he was praying, and then he saw an angel and he saw him face to face. And he said, Cornelius, that your prayers and your offerings have gone up to God. And then send for Peter so that he comes and tells you what comes next. And then he went to to Peter, he gave him a little sleep, and he showed him other things. And then he told him that there are people who are coming to pick you up, home with them, because God can speak to you through a vision. He can speak to you through a vision. And let me tell you this, my brother. One of the things that destroys us is that when it comes to that, some people say, you know, I don't get visions. I don't get visions. But I do dreams. Do you think you can box God? You can box God in a box?
The way God wants to work in your life.
God speaks to me only this way. But if he wants to use a vision, allow him to use a vision. It's not for freaks and all those people. So we are Omega Church. We are the .coms. Allow God, even if you have a PhD, to allow God to speak to you. Even if you have money, you are rich, allow God to speak to you. But if you leave that Christianity which doesn't have revelation, it will not serve you of anything. But we want to have Christianity that speaks with God. So that he speaks to you in some ways. And then he speaks in your life. And then he will build your marriage. Because he's a God that
does speak.
Another way God can speak to us is through a word of knowledge. He makes you know some things that you didn't know. And that you need to know. So that word of knowledge is also a way God speaks to you. 1 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 8. The Bible says that one of us may be given a word of knowledge. But God also can give you a word of wisdom. That's also another way God can speak to us. So that word that when you speak it to me, that will come and destroy so many things in my life. And it will also build other things. Because it's a word of knowledge or wisdom that God is giving you to speak this time, and it will build some things and destroy some things for the glory of God. So that's also found in 1 Corinthians 12:8. It's that same passage that I just quoted. But God can also speak to you through people. The reason why I put this one towards the end some people may say I'm not coming from Changugu, so God cannot speak to me. The reason why I'm saying that is because about 70% of the prophets that are going around
here are from Changugu.
So sometimes when they know that you come from Changugu, they behave so that you may not discern them. So that's why I put it in the middle. I didn't want to start with it. So that I first of all emphasize the fact that God wants to speak with you. Let me tell you this. Do you know that God is our Father? I don't have a child yet. But sometimes I imagine what happens with those who have children. Imagine when you want to talk to Teta and you pass through the servant or the maid, the house help. Go and tell Teta, and Teta is there next to you. Go and tell Teta that So Teta cannot come straight to you as
your father.
I'll go and tell my dad that. So for those who were not born in families with a very tough dad, you may not understand what I'm saying. Sometimes people think that we cannot go straight to our father. If you, whatever you need to talk to your dad about, you have to go through your mom. I think that's probably what it reflects in Catholics, where they speak to God through Mary. And then please tell your son that. Please tell your son that. Jesus Christ is not that. So he wants to speak with you, he wants to have a relationship with you. So that's what I'm telling you, brethren.
It's
so that God may use other people to speak to you. But it's not the only way that God should speak to you. So how does he go through other people? He may use prophets. I'm not calling myself a prophet, but you may use me. But there are times that God tells me, go and speak to this person. But that means that you should be scared. I'm just a sinner as anyone with a lot of grace. And it doesn't change me as a prophet. God doesn't always give me things concerning other people. Sometimes he also speaks to me directly. That's why I'm saying we're going to see that scripture to not despise the prophecies, but he can use prophets. He can even use another person that you wouldn't ever imagine. You are just there talking, having a normal conversation, and you are talking about ordinary things. And a person says something, and then you say, thank you. That God just spoke to me. Let me add another one. He can even use a pagan non-saint, and he speaks to you, and your life is changed. Using a pagan, a person, and non-believer. Maybe I've told you this before, but one day, we are learning, studying, and they sat. And then I was behaving as I'm taking a camera. And one lady looked at me and said, and he was an unbeliever. She said, and Lambert, there are colors that do not fit a dog. And I said, God, thank you. And forgive me, please. I had just becoming like another person. And I didn't know who I was, but you just used an unbeliever to rebuke me. That was a rebuking from the Holy Spirit coming from an unbeliever. Another time I was also in the room. I was still in Butare studying. I was living with I was living with the non-believer, the real and then he would speak to me and tell me, I never see any girl coming. You never ask me to circulate. That's a terminology in Buddha. When a guy would bring a girl for them to do their things, they would ask you the rest to circulate. So you never ask us to circulate. I say it's none of my concerns. So how can a week go by, a month goes by, without you, without having sex? Said, you know, actually, I can go even many years, actually. And then, are you normal physically? So, a person like that, then I was in my room studying. He brought his brethren. They began to shout, and I had an exam I was preparing. And then, sometimes when we are in the spirit, we call them the Philistines, who are not circumcised. Why are they shouting, you know? And then I heard one saying, when I was paying attention, at that very moment I was paying attention, and then they God speak to me through them. And one said, you know my brother, life doesn't have a draft. Life doesn't have a draft. And then I stopped what I was doing. And I reflected about those words. Yes. Yeah. Life doesn't. It's like where you first of all, it's like your first draft. And then you go to, you write again when it's properly written. And then I said that this life that I have, it's this one.
No,
it's this one. It's not like abusing this one as a drug. And then when I give birth, or maybe when I'm old, then I will begin writing on the final version.
The time
that is wasted is gone for good. Are you listening to me? Those are some of the things that have changed my life because God used an unbeliever. So God can use those people. So that's why the word of God says Hebrews,
that
as you see that day coming closer to you, please do not cease to gather together. That even though some have begun to take it for granted,
brethren,
please do not miss out. Because that's where God
speaks.
And he says, our brethren, and he speaks to us. And they tell you, this is not the right
thing.
It can come in a teaching like this, and God is speaking to you through me. It can come as an
example.
And you know very well that this is
that
I need to go this way. I was doing things wrong.
Because
you know that God is using other people. So that's why gathering or fellowship or Sunday service is not an ordinary thing. It's not an ordinary thing. Please. Please, try. People who don't go to HBFs, you are missing out. Please go there. Please go to HBF. If you don't have one, I beg you in the mercies of God, please look for
Pastor Eddie.
Look for Pastor Eddie.
Andre,
or whomever, please, I need to join an HBF. Even if you may not have one, create one. They can even create one just because of that. Praise Jesus. So another way God can speak to you is through circumstances. Things are happening. Things are following a certain pattern, and you see that this is God speaking to me. And when those things are happening, let me tell you this. There's nothing God does without a plan. There is nothing God does just like that. Let me add this. Do you know that even the things that Satan is doing, God takes that, he turns it around and uses it for his glory. That is Romans 8:28. That every single thing, for those who love God, it's not for all. Please read the Bible
properly.
For those who love God, everything works together for their good. Even what the devil is doing, God turns it around, and he makes it for you good. Let me give you an example. You see this beautiful wife of mine that I love so much? There are things that happen. You ask yourself, how would I have met this up, me who are coming from Changugu? I don't mean to say that I've gone through to many countries, but this is a typical example. I am studying. I need to go to Kenya to practice what I had learned. But I have a problem of visa to go to the UK. I need to extend it. I requested for an extension beforehand, and then the visa delayed. My friends took a plane, they flew to Kenya, but I stayed there. And they were praying. People were praying for me. So we had about
400 people,
and they were praying for Lambert for a visa to come. You have to go to Kenya. You are helping us to know things in Africa. But God had his own agenda. What I thank him for, he gave me his peace as we were singing in that song. Actually, the visa came for 3 days for them actually to return to the UK. People cried, people prayed. But in my spirit, I felt I was peaceful. You know that had I gotten that visa, I wouldn't have met Catherine. You don't hear me what I say. Had I had that visa on time, the time that we wanted, I wouldn't be married to Catherine right now. Because after completing my studies
and
Rwanda, I went to South Africa for a training on so, and God took Catherine from US to the UK to learn what actually I was also doing. And they also, all of them, they also have to come to Kenya to also practice what they learned. And then they remember that actually last year, Lambert did not go.
I said,
Lambert, because you didn't go last year, can you come this year and be with us? And say, because that's what God is calling me to do, I can go. So that's how I met Catherine. Had I missed those 3 weeks that we were together in Kenya?
So,
sometimes God uses in the circumstances that you're going
before, so
before you complain to God, ask him, what are you doing
here?
What are you saying in this day? What can I be doing or learning from this? Do I have to learn something today, or it's probably about things that
you're about to do?
So please do not push
to
get out of this. If you have a problem, actually you may realize that that problem, that is the central part of
what
God is doing. So God can use circumstances to speak to you. So God is reminding me that be careful. I'm the one who called you. So this is a
conversation.
And I don't want you to say again that you are not
talking.
There are people who say that they live in a place where they can't hear anything. It's too far away. So I don't want to be
among
those. Because this week God has really spoken
with
me. This week God has really spoken with me. He's spoken to me. And I hope and pray that so another way God can speak to you is through nature. Among the things that God has created. Sometimes we go with our eyes closed. And God wants to use that bird that is actually using a bird that is humming in the morning. Please listen to what God is telling you. Yes. Please listen to what God is doing. You know, nature, the things that God has created, God speaks to us, but sometimes, these are people I know them. These are cars I know them. I know these houses. Because God wants to speak with you. I was painting a place somewhere. It was the first time actually I painted. And then the person trusted me, gave me his paint. And a place to paint. And a brush, and I was painting. After I saw what I had done, I could tell I had just wasted that paint. And then I was scared. So I just spoiled somebody's paint. I just spoiled somebody's place. And I locked the door so that no one would actually come. I left.
And
then I came back the next day wondering, how am I going to fix this? When I came that very morning, and it was very beautiful, you know, when the paint is not dry yet, you can actually look at it and think that you are spoiled. You
know, the paint.
But when you let it dry, and it shows you the beauty. When I looked at that wall, then God spoke to me saying, this is actually what you do sometimes. You want the circumstances to show up, right away. You don't allow me for my faith to cry. And so that whoever is going to see that paint will say, this is something
great.
You want everything to go fast. We are in the .com generation of instant things. So you just click and, you know, things are happening. So sometimes the things of God take some time. So sometimes God uses the circumstances, even the things that you are doing, even nature. I work with the LL Ministries. Do you know where it was born? In a garage. Peter Hobin was fixing a car. And when he looked at the chassis, it was bent like this. And then because he loved the car so much, so that very place. So, and God said, Peter, you like to fix, you know, broken cars. I also like to fix people. What are you going to choose among the two? Sometimes God speaks to you on your computer and you're not listening. And sometimes God is speaking to you when you're driving and you're not listening. And sometimes God speaks to you when you are cooking and you don't
listening.
Sometimes you are just standing waiting for a bus to come and God speaks to you. So pay attention here. So I'm going to end up with this passage in First Thessalonians chapter 5. Verse 19 to 22. The Bible says, do not quench the spirit. Do not despise prophecies. Test all things. Hold fast what is good. Abstain from every form of evil. Let me repeat this. Do not quench the spirit. And whereby you say these people, these other people, God doesn't speak to me. God doesn't speak to me. God cannot speak to me. If you were given the Holy Spirit of God, God wants to use you. So do not quench the Holy Spirit. But do not despise prophecies. Do not despise prophecies. I think there are people who need to repent on that, this passage.
And
we are in the 21st century Christians. We don't walk in those prophecy things. Please do not despise the prophecies. Do not despise the prophecies. Do not despise the prophecies. But it's what you need to do about it. But test everything. Basically, is examine everything. Examine everything and know that this is coming from God. And another thing, hold what is that which is good. That which is good that is coming from God, hold on to it. But the evil one. So what I'm trying to say is this. When you know that God has spoken to you, it's good that you ask for a confirmation. It's good that you ask for a confirmation. If God has spoken to you, it's good that you ask for
confirmation.
The word of God says, sometimes he makes himself an angel, right? So that he lead many astray. So that's why, after hearing what God has said, ask him for a confirmation in his word. So that he uses other people to also confirm those words. So that he uses the circumstances to confirm what he said. So that he confirms what he's spoken to you about. But let me add this one too. It's good that you have people that you trust, especially the leaders, that you approach and tell them that this is what God, I feel God is
saying.
Please help me pray about this thing so that I know the will of God. If it's truly God speaking to me. When I was working in
Jebi,
I began hearing that the voice of God that your time is up here. I'm going to be careful about this. I approached my mentor and other people
as well.
And I told them that I feel God is telling me this. I want you to help me pray about this. Because I don't want to overrun God. But I also want to be left out when God is
born.
So that's why I'm asking that after God has spoken
to me,
have a few people that you
share with
you. And you ask them to help you pray. You ask God to help you
pray.
So that people will know that it's God who has spoken to me. So I want you to listen to everything that I'm saying. Because many people, that is what they fall.
Even
when a prophet comes and you say,
Amen.
You should tell them, thank God. I thank you for obeying God for what you said. Ask God to confirm what you say to me. Not just carrying and taking everything. I don't know if you've noticed, those who are going astray actually are even going faster. Those who are going astray, they run even faster. Slow down. It's not about being down. It's not about despising. But actually examining and prophesying. Are you listening to me? Please let's be upstanding. We're going to pray.
You are here and probably
you think that God can ever speak to
you.
Because of different reasons. But tell God that I didn't believe in this. But I want to believe in this. But from now on, I want to believe in this. I want you to speak to me. In a very personal way. And you are here.
And
God has spoken to you and you are not listening. And today he's reminding you that I was actually the one who spoke to you. So I want you to tell him, God, forgive me. And I know that God is speaking to me. So whatever you spoke to me about, I'm going to put into practice.